Great, Chris Parnell is here. We're going to talk about Archer in just a second. I have been rewatching 30 Rock, which is never loses how funny it is.
It's amazing.
And I can't remember the name of the doctor.
Dr. Spachimin.
See, that's good. Just funny.
Right there.
I
mean, of all these places where you have spread your joy, are there some that stand out to you as favorites? I would imagine that has to be among them.
Well, it was. I mean, the writing on that show is so amazing, you know. So it was a pleasure always to see what they had for me to do. That and Saturday Night Live, and then now just finished recording the 9th season of Archer, which has been pretty amazing.
And then this is an interesting thing we're going to share with you a little bit. Often we will have people here who use their voices in animated projects, or singers, and I can't do it. The vocal warm up.
Yeah.
Right.
That one?
Yeah, that whole thing. They do
it's very
the scales.
Difficult for
him. That whole thing.
Yeah.
Here, Chris explaining to no less than James Corden, do you really do this as warm up for Archer?
Oh. Watch. It's sailors come to the drum out of Babylon, hobby horses foam. The dumb sky rhinoceros glum. Watch the courses of the breakers, rocking horses, and with Colossus, Lady Venus on the settee of the horsehair sea. Or of Tennyson and laurels of the Gloria free, by Sir Albert's Tom Memorial, took the colors of the floral, in a borealic iceberg came Victoria she. Queen Victoria sitting shocked upon the rocking horse of Oasis to the laureate, the Sphinx, of course, is as sharp as any lynx, and blacker deeper than drinks, and quite as hot as any hot and tot, and not the goods for me. For the
oh my gosh, that's
was Nina Dobrov impressed?
Yes, I think she was.
Okay.
Yeah, she was. It was like 3 minutes of great television right.
Is that a real bit?
It is a real thing. It's a real thing I learned in drama school.
Uh-huh.
You know? Yeah. Does it really warm up all the vocal cords and get you to enunciate? Like some people put a pencil in their mouth or whatever.
It does. It's really helpful, yeah. You know.
Cool.
All right, for Archer, Danger Island.
Danger Island.
And is it like a repertory company? Are you a different character this year than you've been in the past?
I am a slightly different character. I'm Siegbert Fuchs. I am a German businessman, supposedly. But it's clear that I'm some sort of a spy.
I see.
Yeah.
Here on the plane to Danger Island, watch this, look.
What's your story? What brings you out here to Midimotu?
Breadfruit. Oh, yeah. I will make a plantation.
A plantation where?
Down there, on the island.
Creating many jobs for our people.
As what? Artisanal coffin builders?
What?
Nothing.
Nothing but danger. That jungle stuffed to the tits with quicksand, ferocious baboons, poisonous snakes.
Poisonous frogs.
The frogs are poisonous?
Often when people do animated projects, you never see the other cast members alone in a booth, or what happens here?
Alone in a booth. Mm. Yeah, I'm on the phone line with the guys in Atlanta who are making the show, and they'll sometimes read a scene back and forth with me, but I'm by myself. And then the cast, we see each other at Comic-Con and things like that.
At premiere parties.
Yeah.
I tell you what, it's rare that a show sustains this many seasons. It's been so funny from the very start.
Thanks. It has. I mean, the writing by Adam Reed is consistently fantastic, and that makes all the difference, you know.
Anything where we're going to see your face in front of a camera soon?
Yeah, I think Life of the Party, this Melissa McCarthy movie.
Yeah. Coming up. How's that?
Fantastic. Yeah, I've got a little part in that, so that's coming out in a couple of weeks, I think, a few weeks.
It's all going Chris's way.
I can't complain.
The Archer Danger Island premiere, that'll be Saturday, April 25th, 10 o'clock on FX's sister station, FX. X. Chris, good to see you this morning.
Thank you, Chris.
Thank you. Coming up.